Very good morning, my dear students of class 12th. You start from line number 155, the speech of Alonso, lecture number 4. Irreparable is the loss and patience says it, the past are cure. Alonso says, my loss is irreparable and patience is of no avail. My loss is incapable of being repaired. It cannot be amended, and I cannot learn to bear it patiently. Prospero says, I rather think you have not sought her help of whose soft grace for the like loss I have sovereign aid and rest myself content. Prospero says, I think you have no patience whose gentle comfort for a similar loss I have had its help, and I am quite content now with my loss and rest myself content. I am quite content now with my loss. Alonso says, you the like loss? How? You have had a similar loss. Prospero says, as great to me as late, and supportable to make the dear loss have I means, much weaker than you may call to comfort you, for I have lost my daughter. Prospero says, my loss is recent and similar to yours. To make my loss bearable, I have much lesser means, much lesser resources than you have to comfort you, for I have lost my daughter. Alonso says, a daughter? Oh heavens, that they were living both in Naples, the king and queen there, that they were. I wish myself were murdered in that oozy bed where my son lies. When did you lose your daughter? Alonso says, have you lost your daughter? Oh heavens, I wish they means your daughter and my son, were both alive in Naples as the king and queen. I wish instead I was buried in the same grave in the sea where my son lies buried. When did you lose your daughter? Prospero says, in this last tempest I perceive these lords at this encounter do so much admire that they devour their reason and scarce think. Their eyes do offices of truth, their words are natural breath. He says, in this last storm I perceive these lords are so wonderstruck, astonished at this encounter, meeting, that they lost their senses to reason. They can hardly believe what they see and hear. But howsoever you have been jostled from your senses, know for certain that I am Prospero, and that were very duke which was thrust for of Milan, who most strangely upon the shore where you were wrecked was landed, to be the lord on it. But no matter how much they have lost their senses, I assure you that I am Prospero. I am indeed that very duke who was banished, who was exiled from Milan. Under strange circumstances, I landed on this shore where you have been wrecked to become its ruler. Know more yet of this, for it is a chronicle of day by day, not a relation for a breakfast, nor befitting this first meeting. Well, no more of this for the present, because it is a chronicle. It is a story to be related from day to day. It is not a story, he says, not a relation for a breakfast, nor befitting with the first meeting. It is not a story which can be told at the breakfast or at the very first meeting. Welcome, sir. This sells my coat. Here have I few attendants and subjects, none abroad. Pray you look in, he says. Prospero says, welcome, sir. I welcome you, sir. This cell is my royal court. I have a few attendants here, and I have no subject in the outside world. Look inside, sir. Look inside, my dukedom, since you have given me again, I will requite you with as good a thing. At least bring forth a wonder to content ye as much as my dukedom. I would repay you with something equally good. At least I can create a miracle to please you as much as you, my dukedom, has pleased me. As much as my dukedom has pleased me, I will please you. The entrance of the cell opens and discovers Ferdinand and Miranda playing at chess. They were playing at chess. Miranda says, sweet lord, you play me false. Dear lord, you are cheating me. You are cheating me. Ferdinand says, no, my dear love, I would not for the world. I would not do so for the entire world. I would not do so for the entire world. Miranda says, yes, for a score of kingdoms you should wrangle, and I would call it fair play. Yes, if 20 kingdoms were at stake, you would argue with me. But out of love for you, I would say what you did was right. Alonso says, if this prove a vision of the island, one dear son, shall I twice lose? If what I am seeing were to prove another illusion in this island, he is not confident whether he is Ferdinand. He says, if what I am seeing were to prove another illusion in this island, then I would lose my dear son twice. Sebastian says, a most high miracle. What we see is a great miracle. Ferdinand says, though the seas threaten, they are merciful. I have cursed them without cause. Though the seas seem threatening, they are merciful to me. They are kind to me. I cursed them earlier without any reason. I cursed them, cursed the sea without any reason. He kneels before Alonso. Alonso says, now all the blessings of a glad father come pass thee about. Arise and say how thou camest here. Now may all the blessings of a happy father embrace you from all sides. Arise and tell us how you reached here. Miranda says, oh wonder, how many goodly creatures are there here. How beauteous mankind is. Oh brave new world that has such people in it. Miranda is in jubilant mood. He is very happy. She says, what a wonderful sight. How many attractive people are here. How beautiful mankind is. Oh, how beautiful and new this world looks, which has so many people in it. Prospero says, that is new to thee. This is new to you. Alonso says, what is this maid with whom thou wast at play? Who is this young lady with whom you are playing? Your eldest acquaintance cannot be 3 hours. Is she the goddess that hath served us and brought us thus together? You could not have known her for more than 3 hours. Is she the goddess who first separated us and has now brought us together? Ferdinand says, sir, she is mortal. She is a human being, but by immortal providence, she is mine. But she is a human being who was given to me by God. I chose her when I could not ask my father for his advice, nor thought I had won. I chose her as my future wife when I could not get my father's consent. She is daughter to the famous Duke of Milan, of whom so often I have heard renown, but never saw before, of whom I have received a second life and second father. This lady makes him to me. She is the daughter of the famous Duke of Milan, of whose fame I had heard of so often, but whom I had never seen before. He gave me a second life, and who has become a second father to me, as his daughter has agreed to marry me. Alonso says, I am hers. But oh, how oddly will it sound that I must ask my child forgiveness. Alonso says, and I will be her father too. But oh, how strange it is that I have to ask forgiveness from my son. And what happens after that, you will study in my next video. My next video will start from line number 225. Thank you so much, students.